If you're thinking about Monday's workload causes you to feel overwhelmed and anxious, then this is for you.
Yes, there's a new way of tackling the Sunday Scaries, and it's called Bare Minimum Mondays.
Hey Nina, how's that script coming?
I've done half of it. That's enough for a Monday.
We all know Mondays can be punishing. So there's a new way to take the pressure off. It's called Bare Minimum Mondays, when you prioritise self-care over production.
Hello, yes, I'd just like to make an appointment for a cut and colour, please.
So, what is it? How does it work? And could it get you fired?
And for more on this, we're joined by wellness consultant Jane Kennelly. Thanks for your time, Jane. What is Bare Minimum Mondays and how does it combat the Sunday Scaries?
Perhaps it would be a good idea to put a bit of an explanation around Sunday Scaries, because if you can imagine sitting on the couch on a Sunday afternoon and you've got some friends and family there and the sun's going down, and then all of a sudden it hits you that Monday is just around the corner and that anxiousness starts to really creep up. And it's actually that anxiousness that is uniquely and only Sunday, and that's called the Sunday Scaries. So the whole notion of this concept about Bare Minimum Mondays is a way that you can enter into the working week with some control and some structure around what you're doing so that it doesn't feel quite so stressful and that you feel that you can actually put your best foot forward. But it's all about being really, really mindful about how you enter the working week on a Monday.
So do you think it's a good way for people to deal with their workload?
These days call for a lot more thinking time. They call for people to be really on game, showing up, really, really ready for whatever the week throws at them. And you cannot be in the fast lane the whole time. So it's a lovely notion and it's a super way for people to just reset themselves and get ready to go. And it's a great way for organisations to get the best out of their people.
Jane, a lot of people talk about work-life balance. Is this a good strategy to combat burnout, do you think?
Look, I absolutely do. You know, I've been doing quite a lot of research in the burnout department recently and over the last few years. It's this insidious thing that kind of creeps up on you, and before you know it, you know, you're accepting meeting after meeting after meeting and there are no breaks and it's all go. And burnout would suggest that it can be controlled. You can manage it if you put some really good strategies in place to look after yourself. And this Bare Minimum Monday is actually such a lovely notion. And when I first heard about it, I kind of went, oh, it makes such perfect sense, doesn't it?
Jane, would it be in organisations' best interests to foster something like Bare Minimum Mondays?
Yes, I do believe so. And certainly with my wellbeing hat on, I believe that equally as strongly. I mean, we are moving into really uncharted territories now, both as employees and also as employers. It's complex, it's really involved, we've got technology coming at us, we don't know what the skills of the future are, but we do know that one of the most wonderful group of people that we need to look after are our own employees. So I think organisations are looking for tips and tricks and ideas and running courses and seminars, but this is such a lovely way to actually say to people, we trust you, we give you permission to actually come into our work environment, set yourself up and do the very best that you can. And in order to do that, take some time to get it all right and get structured.
Thanks so much, Jane. Great talking to you.
Good talking to you both and happy Monday.